Before beginning any repairs on your heat press, be sure to unplug the press from the wall outlet and unplug the power cord from the back of your press. Remove the four screws securing the housing cover from the housing unit. Three of the screws are indicated here and the fourth is on the back side of the cover. Carefully lift off the housing cover and using a number 6 Phillips screwdriver, unscrew the control board bracket from the housing cover. Now, using a number 1 Phillips screwdriver, unscrew the control board from the top control housing. You'll need to hold the small nut on the end of the screw while performing this step. Be careful not to lose the nuts. Here's an up-close look at the wires we'll be working with. Two wires from the control board to the switch, then on the front side of the control board, the strain gauge wire, the wire from the magnet to the control board, the temperature probe connection, and the two cloth-covered wires located in position 3 and 5 on the terminal block. Unplug the wires from the on-off switch. From the front side of the control board, unplug the strain gauge wire and pull it back through the bracket. Unplug the wire coming from the magnet. Unclip and unplug the red and green temperature probe wire. And finally, unplug the ground wire from the control board. On the terminal block, unscrew and remove the cloth-covered wires from the terminals 3 and 5. Now that the old control board assembly is free, set it aside and replace it with the new one from Hotronix. We'll reverse the steps for our new control board assembly. Attach the cloth-covered wires to terminals 3 and 5 on the terminal block. The wires are numbered to ensure that you put the correct wire on the correct terminal. Pass the strain gauge wire through the bracket and attach it to the front of the control board. Plug in the temperature probe wire, the ground wire, and the magnet wire. And finally, attach the last two wires to the on-off switch. Here's how the strain gauge wire passes through the bracket. Before replacing the housing cover, carefully remove the faceplate and set it aside for later. When fitting the control board assembly into the housing cover, be sure to slide it under the retaining clips. Insert the screws into the control board bracket and secure it to the housing cover. Thread the control board screws you removed earlier through the top control housing and the control board. Carefully place the nut over the end of the bolt and hold in place while tightening. Be sure not to over-tighten these, as they could damage the board. Replace the housing cover on the housing unit, insert the on-off switch into its slot, and close up the housing unit. Secure the housing cover to the housing unit with the four screws removed earlier. Plug the press's power cord into the back of the heat press and the other end into the dedicated outlet. Turn on the heat press. The number displayed shows you the version of the new control board, in this case, version 8. You are now ready to calibrate the temperature and pressure. To begin, set the temperature to 350 degrees. Press the center button again and set the first timer to 10 seconds. Press the center one more time and set the second timer to 10 seconds. And finally, press the center button to exit the setup mode and allow the press to heat up. Once the press has come to temperature, place one of the test strips supplied on the center of the lower platen. Lock the press down using medium pressure. After opening, check the temperature reading on the test strip. If the test strip and the control board match, then you can move on to setting your pressure. If they don't match, turn off the press, and with one hand, hold in the two outer buttons on the control panel and turn the press back on. You can now raise or lower the control panel temperature to match the reading of the test strip. Press the center button on the control panel to complete the process. Now turn the press off and lower the upper platen. Turn the pressure adjust knob to the left to loosen the pressure off the platen. Now begin turning the pressure adjust knob to the right, just until the press opens itself. Mark the front of the knob for reference for a later adjustment. Here we used a piece of thermal tape as our marker. Hold in the plus and minus buttons at the same time and turn the press on. Once the press powers up, release the plus and minus buttons, press the center mode button, and the display should read 555. Here is the pressure adjustment screw we will be working with. Press the plus button once. The pressure display will show a number between 1 and 9. Turn the small screw below the pressure display gently to the left or right until a zero is obtained. Press the plus button until a 1 is flashing. Lock the press into the print position, then press the plus button. The pressure display will flash 9. Using caution, as the press will release on its own, press the minus button. Turn the pressure adjust knob clockwise, 1.5 turns to heavy pressure. Lock into print position and press the plus button. The 9 will quit flashing or slow down. Using caution, as the press will release on its own, press the minus button. Now put the control panel faceplate back onto the housing unit. You are now ready to perform a test print. You have just successfully replaced your T-shirt press control board. If you require additional service support, call 1-800-727-8520.